Let's get things shaken.
Previously on Beauty, the remaining teams begin to second-guess their decision to keep William and Jen in the house.
Wow, you just insulted her by implying she's at a lower level.
This can't.
Jasmine faced her worst fear in the zoology challenge.
You have a snake that's come out.
As Sam continued his dominance over the beauty challenges.
Sam won another competition. This is getting old.
Dave saves his team in the Geek's Flair bartending challenge.
I gotta go with Dave.
Sending William and Jen and Jay and Joshua into the elimination room. Even though Jen and William continue to bicker.
Don't ever see myself hanging out with you, though.
They prevailed and sent Jay and Joshua home.
We're getting closer and closer to the end, and I want to win this.
Tonight, just three teams remain, all in the quest to become more than just a beauty and a geek.
Final three, I can't believe it. It's amazing. Like, I'm shocked. Like, especially when William and I were, like, really not getting along and fighting and stuff. I was like, oh, for sure, we're going home. Now, obviously, I want to go for the gold.
I hear footsteps.
Shut up.
I see footsteps.
Who's that? Hey,
wait, wait.
Oh, my God.
The team that will not die.
Back.
Super two.
William and Jen came through the door, and they were the team I was hoping would come back because that would give them more of a chance to work out their interpersonal problems.
Yeah. All right, guys, moment of silence for Shane and Joshua.
Who's farting?
Yeah, that one went really well.
Like, every now and then, like, I do feel like I'm making a connection with some girl, and it's like, oh, you're much more interested in this other guy. And then they go off together and, I don't know, get married or have children.
I've had a crush on Nicole since I've been in the house, but
telling her anything now would just be awkward. So I decided to not say anything, and I don't know.
Back in high school, I remember, there's a girl who I liked, and my uncle died. And when I got back from the funeral, she had a boyfriend.
David is sweet, and he's really funny. Hanging out with him feels comfortable. So he and I will often talk a lot.
Girl meets boy. Boy seems interested in girl. Boy stops being interested in girl.
I didn't date at all in high school.
Seems like there are better ways to spend your time.
Maybe when all this is over, I can work up the courage to finally ask her out on a date.
I'm just preparing myself for the next challenge. I would love for it to involve some sort of physical tasks. I think that's one of my advantages. Whatever gets thrown my way, bring it on. I'm ready to go.
Oh, my.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
How's everybody doing?
Pretty good.
I see you're doing very well.
Yeah, starting the morning off right.
You guys like wine, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know how anyone can enjoy it. It's acidic. It's tart. You know, it's not a pleasant taste.
And the great thing about wine is that after it's bottled and shipped out to the world, it continues to mature for years to come. Much in the same way that you'll take what you've learned here at the mansion and continue to grow long after you've left. Now, keep all of that in mind during your next challenge, which will be in wine country. Woo-hoo! You guys are going to a vineyard.
Wine. I'm like, yeah, let's drink. Let's get happy, you know?
Now, with only three teams left, this next challenge will be a team challenge. The winners are guaranteed to make it into the final two. On the flip side, the two losing teams will face off in the elimination room. This is the team challenge where you guys have to work together to win. There's a lot riding on this challenge. We are ridiculously close to the end. which means you are ridiculously close to the $250,000. Now, you've all made it this far because of your ability to transform as individuals and as teams. You guys still have not won.
Yes.
No one has ever won Beauty and the Geek and not won a challenge.
Gotcha.
Jen and I have had a lot of our difficulties because we are both stubborn, but with this challenge, both have the same objective, and so it's a time we can both come together.
And I suggest you start studying all about Chardonnays and Zinfandels right away. I will see you all at the vineyard.
Sorry. I'm like, how about you?
Are you ready to stomp some grapes?
Yes, I am.
What are the things we need to learn before the challenge?
I would like to win something and feel like I'm helping out Sam for once instead of him carrying me along with him.
I have no intention of going into the elimination room.
I know if I go, I'm going to be petrified and, like, I don't study well. Mm-hmm. Like, this packet, it will take me a week.
We've done it so far.
Okay. You think it's going to be a race? Here I am, like, I get winded really easily and I'm lazy. Sam's so strong.
Sam is strong. Sam has won 5 out of the 8 challenges. He is a giant, but if anyone can take him down, it's us.
It's us. Sorry, can I have a high five?
Yeah, really?
I'm really just going over different kinds of wine right now. Rieslings and Cabernet and...
Cabernet.
No.
Cabernet.
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 Really, I mean Cabernet.
There's no Cabernets. I think that's just silly. Why would you say that? It's Cabernet. Everyone knows that.
Cabernet.
Cabernet. Cabernet.
Oh.
Mr. Know-It-All doesn't listen to me, and I really feel that that's partially why we haven't won a challenge yet, so we need to definitely, like, work together.
Cabernet. It just created, it was created right now.
Yeah.
We walk up to the challenge, and there's some little stomping bins. The second you see them, you can tell, okay, somebody's going to be stomping some grapes.
I was like, oh, piece of cake, no problem.
Jasmine and Dave, Jen and William, Sam and Nicole, welcome to the Beauty and the Geek Vineyard. A win today guarantees that your team will be in the final two.
It was going to be a toss-up between, like, my team, myself and William, and then Sam and Nicole, because Sam's athletic, I'm athletic. Dave and Jasmine are clearly not athletic.
This is going to be comedy. I dread comedy.
Jasmine and Dave, Jen and William, Sam and Nicole, welcome to the Beauty and the Geek Vineyard. A win today guarantees that your team will be in the final two. It means that you will be able to face off against one other team for $250,000. Now, on the other hand, losing this challenge guarantees that your team will be in the elimination room.
Jen and I haven't won a single challenge, but I'm really pumped about this challenge because this is our chance.
All right, here's how the challenge works. First, you need to pick 20 pounds of grapes from the grapevines. Then, transfer them to the wine stomping cask. Next, you must stomp on them using the traditional stomping equipment, bare feet. After you've collected enough juice in your wine bucket, it's off to the bottling station. There, you'll have to bottle, cork, and label 3 bottles of wine. The team that crosses the finish line together with their 3 bottles first wins the challenge. Now, since this challenge is all about teamwork, you'll have to work together closely. Very closely. As in, you will literally be tied together.
When I heard that I had to be tied to William, I would have rather been tied to, like, another guy.
When he said we were gonna have to be tied together, I was like, no way. Davis is like 6 foot, I'm like 5'3". So I was just like, oh, this is gonna be so much harder than I thought it was gonna be.
I often trip and fall just by myself. When I'm tied to another person, that increases the chances of falling exponentially.
When I hear that we're going to be tied together, I'm thinking maybe this might slow me down a little bit. But at the same time, too, I'm thinking maybe this will speed her up a little bit if she's attached to me.
All right, now that you guys are tied up at the waist and ankles, you ready?
Yeah.
Bring me 3 bottles of wine. On your mark. Get set. Go.
One, two.
My strategy with Jasmine was just count it out. It is possible to carefully maneuver yourself down the hill. Slow and steady wins the race, they say.
One, two, stop. As we were going down the hill, like, William kept being like, oh, wait, hold on. Like, he was just too afraid of, like, falling and, like, getting hurt. And I was like, I don't care.
I'm going, and if you want to come along, that's fine.
One.
There were a couple times where I thought Nicole was going to take a face for a spill, but we made it to the grapes.
You good?
Yeah.
Right here, in front of us.
You good?
Let's slide down a little bit and go for one of those.
We had to each get 10 pounds in our bag. And I'm like, I don't know what 10 pounds feels like. I'm like, that's a lot.
I'm decimating this bush, I'm not gonna lie.
But let's make sure I go over instead of under, you know?
Okay, Sam, is this 10?
Think you're good?
I don't know.
Think you got 10?
I don't know. You're the weight guy. What does 10 pounds feel like?
Need more. Here, come down here.
To me, my bag felt very, very heavy. I felt that since he was, you know, experienced with weights, he might know what 10 pounds felt like.
I think I got 10 pounds.
Ready, and up. Okay, well, I wasn't really sure if we had enough, but Jensen, let's go ahead and pull. So I'm thinking, all right, let's go ahead and take a chance. We might make it.
This is good. This is my bag will not hold anymore. Let's go. Okay.
I was walking up the hill, and I was like, I do not want to go down this hill again. And I was like, please let this be enough grapes, because I knew if we had to go back down, like, we were done for.
Run.
All right, I go first.
Got it.
It's fine. We're good. Yes! I have enough grapes!
Got it?
Yeah,
these were Nicole. It was really slow. Maybe within the first 30 seconds, I probably had like 50 pounds worth of grapes.
Shoot, I only have 7. How many do you have?
6.
Shoot, come on.
Oh, yeah?
Okay.
When I saw that we only had like 7 pounds instead of 10, my heart just sunk. I was like, no, this is not good.
All right, come on. Ready? Okay. Got it.
Okay.
They're coming down.
They are?
Yeah.
Then you come out. We're the only ones there, and we were in the lead. And we're like, oh my gosh, like, no one's around. Like, I'm shocked right now. Right here. Okay, it's not coming out.
Hold on. I was busy stomping grapes, and I noticed something is wrong here. Why isn't it leaking out?
There was a point where we finally decided that we should head up, because Dave and Jasmine were already so far ahead.
Smash him! Wait, yep. How much do you need still?
I don't know.
Should we just go back and see?
Yep, let's go.
Okay, let's go.
She had 10 pounds. I think I probably had like 15 or 20 pounds. It's just a ridiculous amount of grapes.
It's stuck. We have more than enough juice. It's just not coming out.
We had so much problems getting the grape juice out of our barrel that we had to literally take the spigot off.
Oh, man, it's pushing. There we go.
We waited a second time. We had 20 pounds. We're like, all right, let's go dump it into the barrel. Come on, I'm about to quit.
Come on.
Orange, and then, you know, it's fine, it's not the orange. And so, you know, put on our shoes, they're all squishy and grapey, and so we walk over with our bucket.
Okay, careful.
Let us pour.
Hey, really, David, are you shaking? Because I can pour.
No, I agree.
Holding the funnel, and it's spilling over the sides a little bit, so I'm worried we're not going to have enough for 3 bottles.
I'm pretty nervous when I'm seeing Dave and Jasmine running over to bottle their wine. I'm thinking, this is not good. I was like, they're way ahead of us.
Is that going to count?
Yeah. Unless it's
we'll top it off. We'll top it off later. Okay, we're done.
Two victory. One.
Jasmine and Dave were already way ahead of us. I was hoping maybe they might like break some bottles along the way or something.
One. Jasmine and I filled up 3 bottles on a tray, and Mike was standing several yards away, and we were walking towards him, and one of those bottles fell. It was over.
Okay.
Mr. Richards.
Two.
I believe.
One, two.
You placed
one,
an order
two.
For some Cabernet Sauvignon. And here. Congratulations, you did it. You won.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
You are in the final 2.
Final 2, baby!
Final 2!
Can you believe it?
Yeah!
This also means that William and Jen, Sam and Nicole, will be facing off in the Elimination Room tomorrow night.
Not looking forward to elimination. Not winning again. It was horrible.
I was just like, oh, sucks. Not only were we going into eliminations, but we're going up against Sam and Nicole. Sam and Nicole, who win everything.
We were ridiculously confident we would be able to beat Dave and Jasmine. I was wrong. I mean, that sucks. Because I do not want to go down to that elimination. I don't want to even go down there.
You have a 1 in 2 chance of winning $250,000.
Yeah, that's a lot of money.
That was some good teamwork there, wasn't it?
That was
it?
Great teamwork. Yeah. We're a good team.
You finally made it to the final two, and it was one of the most fantastic moments of my life.
Yes! Oh, my God!
A cheer went up so loud that it was held throughout all of the Malibu region of California.
After the challenge, we got to go on top of this mountain at this gorgeous house, this gorgeous view, and have wine and cheese with everyone.
Delish.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. And
cheers.
To winning the last challenge. Congratulations.
Thank you.
We had, you know, 2 kinds of wine. We had a meal, like, fit for a queen.
Bon appetit.
All right, cool. I feel like a king and queen right now.
You deserve it.
Thank you. This is my first time I won.
Do you not love it?
I do love All right. it. Gosh.
You okay, sir?
Sam, eat something.
There's a fly on it when I got here.
Would you like some of my fly free food?
I feel bad for Sam as we're sitting down at dinner. I think he's still upset about the challenge.
He didn't eat anything. He was just sitting there pissed off that he didn't win a challenge.
So there's wine.
I think we've now got another little piece of who Sam really is. He likes to win, and so he's really only happy-go-lucky when things are going his way.
It's me and Dave's moment, and it turned into Sam's problem. It's not fair.
Coming back to the house, I think the first thing I want to do was to hit the books. Just go ahead and cram because I'm not ready to go yet.
I think we'll do all right because that is too bummed out to study.
I know, because that gives us like the advantage. He's too bummed out. Sam's acting like I was such a bad sport, which is why I'm gonna like try and do my best to elimination to kick his butt. I think if we put our mind to it, just go in there, give it a go.
I'm not gonna give up now that I've come this far.
I know.
A wine scientist.
Owenologist.
Yes.
William always thinks he can do everything by himself. He likes to, he's like, well, just read your stuff and then we'll talk, you know? But today, we're definitely working together closer.
Well, today's elimination day, and Jen and I are face up against Sam and Nicole. And Sam is just livid because he's won so many. So when he lost this challenge, he was just unbelievably frustrated. And Jen and I are hoping to capitalize on that. Like, hoping that he's just so mad that he can't really see straight and not really into studying.
All I wanted to do was make it to the end of the journey.
Me too.
And I did that.
Yeah, me too. Dave and I, we made it. We're safe. Got in the final two. It's just so awesome.
Who'd have thought that, you know, we could work together so well?
I know.
I'm very satisfied right now.
Me too. You did a good job.
Yeah.
Guys, look!
There's a surprise for you. Please head into the study.
I want to pretend that it's a good surprise.
Oh my gosh, look, guys. We're going to watch something.
Sweet.
Dave, come sit next to me.
So we went into the study, and there's a TV set up. So I'm like, we're all thinking, like, okay, what's going to happen? Like, what are we watching?
What is this? Oh, my gosh. I'm so curious.
I was really hoping it was going to be, like, Mike Richards coming on saying that, like, eliminations is canceled. You know, we don't have to do it, which would have been awesome, but no.
Oh, God.
Oh, my gosh, it's science. I just did a flip.
I thought that this might be ourselves on the first day, and that was accurate.
Actually, my name's David. I'm a LARPer. And I'm getting... So I'd like to demonstrate if anyone would like to fight me.
I'm fighting. I can't watch.
All right, so now we fight.
Dave on that video is me. It's a different form of me. I was scared. I feel like I've gained some confidence, and I am more relaxed now.
When I found out that Jasmine became my partner, I thought, oh dear Lord, I just screwed myself.
David!
Right here, right now.
Make a run for it, David, go.
You were actually last on my internal list of partners.
I was last. I remember vividly when he said that, and when he told me, I don't want to be your partner, I took it as, oh my gosh, I'm going home. Like, oh my gosh, I'm not going to get along with this person. We have to share a bedroom. This sucks. I'm last on your list. Thanks a lot.
No.
No. You're sleeping on the floor tonight.
Oh, man.
Cup two!
I don't have any regrets of Jasmine being my partner because, I mean, I just look at the results and see what we've accomplished together.
So in the past, right?
Yeah.
And we can forget that ever happened.
Yes. He shouldn't feel like a jerk. He was just being honest. He didn't know. And maybe that's why he doesn't have a girlfriend because he doesn't know how to lie, but whatever. I'll get over it.
I don't read a lot. I mean, I don't want to, like, I want to go out and do stuff.
Certainly, originally, he was just here to have a good time. He wasn't much into studying, but now he's incredibly intense about it.
I would totally tell a geek that is, you know, like needs help, that just do it. It's not that hard. I mean, come on.
Do it.
Stop being a geek. Be cool.
Thanks, Sam.
I mean, really, like...
I thought that was just so funny. It was cool to look back and think of how different we are now than we were when we first walked in the door. I don't know exactly where that transition happened.
I've been to a few clubs. That's not really my scene. I don't like it when it's so loud. You can't talk to people. And I have issues with personal space.
Yes, you do. That's true.
I don't really know how to interact with boys as anything other than the kid's sister friend type, so. I don't know if I look that way now, but I certainly don't feel that way. I don't have to keep my guard up as long as I think I do. I can let it down more quickly and not hold back so much.
So is she what you thought she would be?
Yeah, kinda, I guess.
Awkward.
Now what about you? I'm sure you thought about it.
This is what I expected. I'm a little buttoned up, so I thought my opposite might be a little less buttoned, which I would say you are.
I guess.
After the challenge, I was in a very bad mood. But then, the coolest part about seeing the video was the fact that I realized that I have learned how to learn stuff. And now, my goal is just do it. Do my best and win.
Awesome.
Where's that from?
That was the second that me and Nicole met. Literally, like, that was, like...
Yeah, like, we walked up the driveway.
I'm gonna try and use the force to not show Jen and mine.
Technical difficulties, go!
Uh-oh. Wow.
Damn it.
The next team we're gonna put together will be Jen.
This is a great day.
And William.
Hey.
Wow.
Sorry, you stuck with me. Yeah.
I'm happy. I'm good. Everyone knows I didn't want Jen as my original partner.
Yeah, Jen.
Muscle weighs more than fat, so.
Wear that.
Hold on. No, muscle does not weigh more than fat.
Oh, man.
What are you doing with that lollipop?
I'm eating it.
Fill a cup of fat, fill a cup of muscle. What do you think, which cup is gonna weigh more? The cup of muscle.
Depending on how many ounces is the cup.
Oh my God.
We're arguing already.
I've always been told everybody that's always talked to me said muscle weighs more than fat.
You're frustrating.
Wow.
Yes, William.
What the heck?
I need to take a minute.
We're gonna breathe. I didn't realize that the trauma started so early between the two of you.
Yeah, it's.
That was so funny.
That was great.
Yeah, wow. That was awesome.
I had somehow grown into thinking that William and Jen's problems were recent, but looking at that scene, the fact is they've been persevering since day one, which is, I guess, more than a lot of us would expect to do in the same situation.
So how do you think your relationship has changed?
We learn to walk away when we argue.
Yeah.
I look at that video, and it reminds me of a lot of the challenges that Jen and I have had, a lot of our difficulties. Now I think that Jen and I know where our limits are, and we know what we need to say or what needs to not be said to come for a peaceful resolution.
All right, that was interesting.
That blast from the past.
I wish William and myself would have like been able to work better with each other, but I think he kind of understands me better and I understand the way he is. So I think, you know, there's maybe a little bit of respect happening there.
It's a wave of nostalgia followed by elimination.
Did you read through all the material?
There's still some bits of the history that I haven't read all the way through, but...
What rank is the United States in terms of world wine production?
I do have a preference for which team would come back tonight, and that preference is for Sam and Nicole, because I really like Nicole, and I'd like the opportunity to spend a few more days with her.
Approximately when was Juan discovered?
Oh. Dave's helping me prepare for elimination because I think he really wants me to have a good shot at being in the final two. The sentiment's really nice.
What are some characteristics of Chianti? I would like Nicole to know that I like her, but I'm afraid that if I try to move things on to the next step when she's not ready, then that friendship would be ruined.
I've known pretty much since Nicole got here, Dave's like there. So how did studying go?
I need your help. I really need your help.
Dave has no experience with girls, so he needs a lot of help with that. I have an idea. With the people that come back, hopefully Sam and Nicole, We should go on dates, like a four date.
Okay.
What's that called? A group date?
A double date.
A double date. Maybe we'll get dressed up.
Before nomination, Jasmine said that we would have a double date if Nicole and Sam came back. I'm still trying to figure out what the definition of a date is.
Wine tasting routine.
Wine tasting routine, swirl, sniff, sip, slosh, spit.
After we lost the challenge, Sam took it very hard. He was very disappointed. But today, we're making flashcards together. We're quizzing each other. And he seems to really be in good spirits. In search of wine, in search of women, in search of themselves.
That would be sideways.
Prohibition.
Prohibition. Prohibition originally started because Americans were going through so much excess. That's the reason why they stopped it.
Because
because people were excessing. People were getting drunk all the damn time because there wasn't really much anything to do.
Elimination is fast approaching, and Jen and I are just quizzing each other back and forth.
I think let's just go in there being confident.
Go with your first instinct. The glove of God.
I have been.
This is so much pressure, and anything can happen, and so I'm unbelievably nervous.
You didn't know this, but I actually absolutely hate conflict. Hate it. With a passion.
I don't like it either. We've pretty much just decided to, like, put everything aside, just forget the past, and just focus on what we need to do.
I'm just glad we were able to, like, pull at least somewhat together for the last ending of this.
Yeah, me too.
At first, you thought I was going to be all spoiled and, like, and I'm I'm actually really not.
Yeah.
What's that look like?
No, I was thinking I was regretting what I said. I was thinking, if only I hadn't been so stubborn.
I'm feeling that if Jen and I were to last a few more days, who knows how well we get along, because 4 days, not arguing. It's a good couple of days.
You got it.
Thank you.
Teamwork after a month.
I know.
Why couldn't we have the challenge before?
I know.
I think just our personalities have evolved, and we now know how to deal with each other.
Don't let being scared get in the way of telling someone that you like them. If you can, say, Nicole, I hope you come back because I like you a lot.
Just before nomination, Jasmine and I were talking a little bit about my attraction towards Nicole.
So is that a yes or no you're going to tell her?
I'm saying maybe.
She might leave tonight, do you understand?
I'm apprehensive about telling Nicole that I have feelings for her because there's the constant fear of rejection.
I think I hear.
You're a troublemaker.
Thank you for being an awesome partner and teaching me so much.
Well, of course. Go kick some butt.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hey. I just want to say one last goodbye, because I'm going to, like, I hope you guys come back for sure. And I'll see you tonight. Like, if you guys come back, we should have, like, a double date kind of thing. And that'd be fun, like, dinner and, like, champagne.
So killer.
You want to go say one last goodbye to David?
Sure.
Mm-hmm. All right.
When Jasmine told me Dave wanted to see me, I'd been focused on elimination and studying, and I wasn't quite sure what he wanted right before I went into elimination.
Yeah.
Hey.
Well, Jasmine was trying to play matchmaker a little bit before elimination, so after mentally preparing myself, I decided to take use of the opportunity to ask Nicole out.
I feel like we should, I don't know, make a date or something. Have you been upstairs on the square? I'll have to take it upstairs in the square.
Okay, where's that at?
Nicole and I both live in Boston, about a 5-minute walk from each other, actually. So I can say, hey, do you want to go get ice cream? And we can go down to Davis Square and get some ice cream.
I hope you come back, because I like you a lot.
We hope so, too. We'll see each other in Boston. I definitely plan to hang out with Dave when we get back to Boston, but I just don't foresee it really getting anywhere.
What happened?
What?
Did you tell her? you liked her?
Yes.
You said, Nicole, I like you and I hope you come back?
Yes.
That's good that you told her I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
When he first came in the house, he would not be able to talk to girls, and that's really hard to put yourself out there. Did you ask her on a date?
Well, maybe.
What did she say?
She agreed that we to go to out to dinner with me.
She did?
Yeah.
You asked her out to dinner?
Yeah. I think I learned something from this, and it is that if you're going to ask a girl on a date, don't psych yourself up for it. Just do it.
I hope she comes back.
Jen and I walk through that elimination room. There'll be pressure like I've never felt before. I don't want to come out of this experience looking like a loser.
Our competition is William and Jen, who have come back twice from elimination. We know that they're a very tough team. And when I go in there, my thought is I'm doing it for my partner. I want to win this for my partner.
William and Jen, Nicole and Sam, welcome to the elimination room. You know, Jasmine and Dave are already in the final two. They're upstairs wondering which of you guys they're gonna go head-to-head with in the finale. Here's how it works. You'll be asked a series of questions about wine. The team with the most correct answers wins. Are you ready?
I'm ready to go for beauty.
Beauties, you'll go first. I need the geeks to step over to the viewing room. Wish your partners good luck. They're gonna need it.
That's how we're gonna.
Wow. You'll each get two questions about wine. Jen, the first pick is yours. Which number would you like?
Four, please.
All right, here's Jen's lucky number four. The color of wine is primarily determined by the presence or absence of what part of the grape during fermentation?
Please get it.
Skin of the grape.
That is correct. All right, Sam, which number would you like?
I'll go with one. Why not?
Who is the Roman god of wine? Diogenes, Dionysus, Bacchus, or Tubuchuchus?
Oh, God, I'm so glad we went over that.
So did we.
Bacchus.
That is correct.
That was straight from Nicole. I did not see that in the material. That was right out of her mouth, right into my ears.
The score is 1-1. Jen, it's back to you. Which number would you like?
Three, please.
Which of these words is primarily used to describe a wine scientist? Ornithologist.
You know this.
Enologist. Or an ichthyologist?
I believe it's ornithologist.
That is incorrect. The correct answer is enologist.
Oh, it is. Damn it, it is.
All right, Sam, it's back to you. You can give Nicole a very nice lead. According to your material on wine tasting, what is the correct order for the following task to optimize enjoyment? Sip, slosh, spit. Slosh, spit, swirl. Or sniff, spit, slosh.
Think them all out.
So sip, slosh, spit, the first one.
That is correct. It is 2-1. Now let's bring our geeks back.
So sorry. No, it was my fault.
William, you're saying it's your fault. Why is this your fault?
We covered this. It's one of the words, that one of the vocab words, and I mispronounced it, so I pronounced it oenology. It threw her, so it's all my fault.
It's not my fault. I should know how to pronounce it too, so I mispronounced it as well.
Yeah.
Okay, beauties, wish your geeks good luck, and then head over to the viewing room. If you get both of your questions correct, you guarantee your spot in the final two. And William, you're just hoping she misses. William, you're up first.
No pressure.
Which number would you like?
I'll go with four, please.
Number four. Using your material as a guideline, arranged these wines in order of how cold or chilled they should be served, from the coldest to the warmest. Red, champagne, and white.
Champagne would be coldest. White would follow after that, but warmer. And then red would be served the warmest.
That is correct. All right, Nicole, you ready?
Yes.
Which number would you like?
Taking number one.
If you're not careful, which of these could make you tipsy faster since it has the higher alcohol content? 8 ounces of Merlot, 8 ounces of port, or neither, as there is no difference?
That would be 8 ounces of port.
That's correct. If you miss this one, you and Jen are out of the game. Which number would you like?
Two.
Number two, he said with confidence. From her Back to Black album, what British singer with a fitting name for this week's challenge first recorded the pit song Rehab? If you get this wrong,
I know.
It is game over.
I know.
Chateau Butte.
That is incorrect. The correct answer is Amy Winehouse. Congratulations, Nicole. You're in the final two. Let's have the beauties rejoin us in the elimination room. Well, Amy, you seem pretty broken up.
I am.
What are you thinking right now?
I wish I'd gone with my instincts.
What was your instinct?
I was going to go for three.
Want to hear what number three was?
I do.
Sake is an alcoholic beverage made from fermenting what main ingredient?
Oh, that's hilarious. That's hilarious.
Let's answer.
It's rice.
Yeah.
It's not my fault. I mean, everything happens for a reason, and
we were just trying to get along, too.
William and Jen, I have to ask you to leave the mansion.
Definitely at one point, I felt complete hatred towards William. You know, I just could not care less if I never saw him again. And then it's just ironic that finally, in the very last week, come together the way we should have, like, a month ago.
I have gained respect for Jen, and came completely out of left field.
Say with me now, muscle is more dense than fat.
Muscle is more dense than fat.
Yes, muscle is more dense than fat. But they weigh the same.
On Beauty and the Geek, the remaining players take a surprise trip.
This is Nicole, my brother Joe.
Then, the team that forever changed the social experiment faces off against the classic Beauty and Geek for the grand prize.
There's something in us that has changed, and it's big, but I don't know what it is.
You'll never guess how this season's winner will be decided. This game is transforming again.
Awesome.
Oh my God.